actress or singer or anyone has a movie coming out, suddenly he starts tweeting way more. He suddenly starts interacting way more with his fans. Or it's not like, achha, meri picture nahi nikalne wali, so oh, I'm gonna like really tweet now, I'm gonna really like get in touch. So at the end of the day, but what you have to realize is that pressure is coming through external forces. As in there's a producer involved, there's a studio involved who's like, you know, please tweet this. So that tweet is not necessarily the actor's tweet. It's a tweet that the, like a studio or a producer is telling this actor that please give this out. Because frankly, social media is like, my film is coming out, Badlapur. Now this is not a PR exercise. I'm just using this as an example. My film is coming out, Badlapur. They ran a viral campaign for it, where we released 5 posters before the teaser. And everything was done virally and digitally. So that means now digitally, when you have to put something on, it costs less than putting it on TV and buying spots, right? So everything is viral and digital, and it's only trying to target that kind of audience. And yet you're creating buzz. And it's surprising because my mom went to like buy a shoe in Linking Road recently. And she went to shop, and the guy showing her the shoe told her, "Arey, unka promo dekha, bahut achha laga." And mom was shocked that how did he see it, because it's only on the net. It's nowhere. She was wondering, how this guy, is he on Twitter? That's what she asked him, ki aap Twitter use karte ho ya kya aap YouTube dekhte ho? He's like, haan, dekhta hai na. So I don't think we totally know the power of social media in the country as yet. I mean, there's no number that we can kind of gauge it with as yet.
That's an excellent point. I have one more question to that. You accept that it is an extension of the PR exercise. At the same time, you are a person with a lot of integrity, I can see from the way you speak. Would you ever lie?
Depends what it's about. Like if it's something about national security or something, and like the Prime Minister called me and told me, "Varun, you need to say this." No, I mean.
We'll keep it simple. What would you lie about?
What would I lie about? Let's just say I wouldn't lie. I'd try to like have guts and say the truth. I'd try to do that.
If we knew we are so hated, we wouldn't get off the bed. You know, the world hates us, and that's what we get on Twitter. So I told him, because I was having an argument, that this...
No, but honestly, very often I feel I'm hated. Very, very often. For example, when Student of the Year, we were promoting Student of the Year, I thought I was the most hated out of all three of us. I'm just saying, at that point, you know, it's very... easy because like there's a whole thing on social media which is fair enough. I don't blame anyone for thinking like that, where they're like, oh, you're a director's son, so probably that's the reason over here. Now tomorrow's probably, if I was born in a family where I was not a director's son and I was becoming an actor, because I'm an actor, I'm supposed to think like everyone. I mean, it's my job to put myself in other people's shoes and think, oh, why is this person thinking that way? Definitely I would think like that, arre isko isliye chance mil raha hai kyunki ye director ka beta. 100%. So the way they are thinking is correct in their mind. But now I knew that becoming an actor, I had to beat that perception. I had to overcome that perception. And lots of people who are probably born in fortunate households or born with a silver spoon or however people want to put it, do go through that. I'm sure Sachin Tendulkar's son is going to go through that when he gets selected for a cricket match or something.